Now I'd like to talk about another pattern that's very common when designing classes. We'll say that a class has a property if it has a value that one can simply get and set. Look at a person. A person has a name. That's a private instance variable, so we'll have a getter that returns the name. And here we have a setter that you can use to set the name to a new name in case the person, for whatever reason, is unhappy with their previous one. It's very, very common to have this pattern. Instance variable, getter, setter. There's some variations. Sometimes you do some error checking in the setter. Here we check that the new name is not the empty string, because no one's name should be the empty string. Or maybe in a particular application, it just shouldn't be allowed to change the name. And in that case, there wouldn't be a setter. This is a read-only property in this example where we just have the instance variable and the corresponding getter. Now, properties, meaning private instance variables with getters and maybe setters, are very common, but that doesn't mean that you should make every instance variable a property with a getter and setter. Only use the getters when there is a need for the user of the class to read the instance variable, and only supply a setter when there is a need for the user to modify it. Many instance variables do not have getters and setters. Well, let's practice that with yet another variation of the car class. This car class has a number of instance variables, and I'd like you to look it over and add getters and setters for those where it's appropriate, and not add them for those where it's not.